So the problem is not actually load balancing. The problem is adding and removing servers, like we saw. That completely changes the local data that we have in each server, right? And to avoid that, we're going to be using this concept where we are still going to be hashing all the requests according to their IDs, right? So request ID is still there. We still hash request IDs. So what's different? Well, what I'm drawing is a ring. And now I want you to imagine that instead of an array, which can map this hash function value from 0 to m minus 1, this is a ring which contains the positions 0, 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth, up to m minus 1. Right? It goes all the way around, and m minus 1 sticks to 0. So it's a ring of hash. Fine. So of course, this thing can be mapped into a point over here. Let's say that point is over here. So this request is pointed over here. We are going to have multiple requests. So these are where the requests are. Now, what we can do is we can take the servers, and we actually need to send these requests to those servers. So the servers themselves have IDs, which are from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? First we had just 4 servers, so these are the server IDs. What I can do is hash these server IDs also using the same hash function, right? Or a different hash function, it doesn't really matter. What I want to do is then take the remainder with the search space, which is m. So I take the remainder with m. And as an example, if I hash 0 mod m is 30, then let's say h of 0 is 49 mod 30 gives you 19. So server 1 will be hashed to position 19. So let's say that is over here. Right, S1. Similarly, let's say S2 is hashed here. We have S3 here and S4 here. Now, whenever a request comes in to this ring that we have, what we do is we go clockwise. We go clockwise and find the nearest server. This server is going to be serving this request. That's it. Simple algorithm. This one is going to be served by S2. This one is going to be served by S3. Or rather, this one is going to be served by S4. This by S2. This by S3. This by S1. In fact, it goes over here to S1, okay? So S1 has load of 2 requests. This has load of 1, and a load of 1, right? So why is this the architecture we are choosing? Because the hashes are uniformly random. You can expect the distance between them to be also uniform. In which case, because the distance is uniform, the load is uniform. The requests are uniform, of course, so they're being mapped to the right places. So the load factor turns out to be, on average, expected, 1 by n. That's the smart bit. But you already had that earlier. That's not the problem. The special thing is, now if I lose a server, let's say S1, or let's first add a server, in fact. So I have a 5th server, right, which is mapped onto this point. Where should I add it? Over here, yeah. This is S4. Then any requests which come in here are going to be served by S4. So initially, these two requests would be served by S3, which would have a load factor of, let's say, 3. But because of S4, these two requests find their nearest clockwise server, which gives S4 the load factor of 2, and S3 comes down to 1. Now, what you're seeing is that the change in each of these servers' loads is going to be much lesser than what was there previously. S1 is not affected, S4 is not affected, S2 is not affected, only S3 is affected. Okay. Now let us say S1 goes down. For some reason, there was a crash. This thing lost its power cord. So we lose this. And good news, all of these requests are now going to be served by S4. And S4 is a happy guy. Not really. The problem with this architecture is that although theoretically the load should be 1 by n, practically you can have skewed distributions over here. And why is that? Because you do not have enough servers. If you had a lot of servers, the chance of this happening was really low. You would have a lot of red points and it would be evenly distributed. But you just have 4 now, and that's why you have about half of the load on a single server, which is terrible. So we know how to add servers and map requests to them. We know how to remove servers and add requests to them. We also know that theoretically it's going to be the minimum change. But practically, how do we make this work? And this is the place where system design, engineers solve problems, right? Take your time, try to think of a solution. Okay. What you can do is you can start making virtual servers. When I say virtual servers, it doesn't mean that you have virtual boxes or you start buying more servers, because those are expensive. What you can do instead is use multiple hash functions. This is H. Why not make it H1 for all of these guys? And then have another hash function, H2, through which you pass the server IDs and get different numbers. So if you have K hash functions, from which you pass each of the server IDs, then each server will have K points. So let's say S3 maps to 2 other points. One is this, S3, one is this. S3 is right here. S4 is mapped to this point and to this point. And what you're effectively seeing is if K is equal to 3, then you'll have, instead of just 4 points, you'll have 12 points. And the likelihood of one server getting a lot of the load is much, much lesser. If you choose the K value appropriately, for example, let's say log n or log m, you can almost entirely remove the chance of a skewed load on one of the servers. Right? So now if a server is removed, you need to remove K points from it and clockwise assign to the nearest servers. But in this case, you can see that the chance of the load being skewed is really, really low, and it is efficient. So if you had a pie now, it's more likely that you're going to just take some load from this server, some load from this server, some load from this server, and some load from this server. Right? The reason for that is because there are multiple points where they exist. Multiple places are going to get removed if you remove one server, and those places will hit multiple regions. So their loads will increase uniformly, expected uniformly. Similarly, if you add a server, again, the same thing is going to happen. You're going to have expected minimum change in the numbers that they serve. So if you're wondering where this can be used, it's used in many, many places. Load balancing is a concept which is used in distributed systems extensively, right? You have this being used by web caches. You have this being used by databases. Consistent hashing is something that gives you flexibility and gives you load balancing in a very, very clear and efficient way. All right? So you should definitely know about this, and you can have a look in the description below for relevant links. I'll be sharing the code for this in the description below again. And if you have any doubts, then you can leave them in the comments below. If you have any suggestions for computer programming or system design videos, you can leave them in the comments below. I'll be happy to have a look at them. Best of luck. And this is what you want to avoid. You know why you want to avoid this? Because when people are making requests to different servers, what you don't want to happen is that if one request depends on the response from this server, you don't want the